Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with lead editorial. Now today's lead editorial, it relates to BRICS. So this editorial for the day, it has relevancy with respect to general studies paper 2. Now when it comes to BRICS is not an institution or an organization, rather BRICS is a grouping of the countries that fall in the domain of developing countries, and these countries, they annually meet. So BRICS is an annual meeting of the developing countries represented by Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. Now in this lead editorial, I will be discussing two aspects. First of all, I will be discussing what is the importance of BRICS. And secondly, I will be discussing the issues confronting India in BRICS. What issues are confronting India in BRICS? Now when it comes to BRICS represents the idea and the vision of the developing countries. So BRICS first meeting, it took place in 2009, and at that point of time there was a global economic crisis. So these countries, they have come together to discuss and analyze the global economic situation at that point of time. And these countries, they wanted to indulge in cooperation between the southern countries, the countries lying in the southern hemisphere, so that they can effectively engage with the countries lying in the northern hemisphere. This is what we called as North-South Dialogue. North and South Dialogue. So BRICS was more about the South and South cooperation. South and South cooperation for what? South and South cooperation in order to counter the ascendantic agenda of WTO. South and South cooperation to institutionalize reforms in United Nations. South and South cooperation to fight against the undemocratic system of IMF. South and South cooperation to institutionalize alternative banking system at the global level in order to counter the hegemony of World Bank. South and South cooperation in order to represent the interest of the developing countries in the domain of climatic change. South and South cooperation in order to present an alternative agenda to the Western-led concept of development. So this was the basic purpose of BRICS. So this is the importance of BRICS as a nation. Now what are the issues confronting India? Now presently, if we look at the membership of the BRICS, it includes countries like Brazil, Russia, India, China and South Africa. Now out of all these countries, the main adversary of India is China. So China basically wants to institutionalize its BRI project, Belt Road Initiative. Now because it wants to institutionalize this very economic project, to which India is not comfortable with, in the upcoming meeting in Xiamen, India will be cornered for this wish of China. So this is one of the basic issue that is confronting India, when it will come up for the discussion, because this issue has already been under discussion in various international organizations. Example, Shanghai Corporation Organization. So BRICS is also going to discuss the same thing at the behest of China. It is China that will be actually pushing for the BRICS countries to discuss this BRI. And already the countries like Russia and South Africa, they are already the members of this BRI initiative. So China, amongst all these countries, it has a lot of influence over South Africa, it has a lot of influence over Russia, and it has a lot of influence over Brazil, because it has done a lot of investment. And when it comes to Russia as a nation, this is another issue that is confronting India. Now Russia is actually getting more aligned towards China. Now if you look at the history of the China and Russia relationship, in 1960s and 70s, they were actually the adversaries. Because both these countries, they were trying to represent themselves as a pioneer of communism. So both the countries were not showing any kind of cooperation. But of late, because Russia's relationship with the European countries, they have touched almost the low. Now Russia is willing to partner economically, politically and socially, partner with China. And this is actually hitting at the India's interest. Now both these countries, Russia and China, they are also willing to expand this BRICS. BRICS is nothing but a discussion forum for the developing countries that meets annually. But now both these countries, they are also willing to include other countries like Pakistan, like Sri Lanka. Now India is actually not comfortable allowing Pakistan to become a member of this BRICS Plus. Now this is another issue that is confronting India. Now how can India come over these challenges and these issues? Now India can come over these issues and challenges by resolving the border conflict that we are having with China. In yesterday's editorial, I had also talked about how India needs to change its strategy about border conflict. How we should actually be resolving the conflict rather than just managing the conflict. Because it's the resolution of the conflict that is really going to yield some positive results. It is not only about the negotiations, because already we have undergone 19 rounds of talk on the border conflict. So this is what this entire editorial is about. Now you can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. And you can also place the order on the video classes on the same website, that is BrainyIAS.com. Now you can also practice answer writing on BrainyIAS.com. We are providing students with artificial intelligence embedded software, that is Magic QA. So you can practice answer writing on Magic QA. You will get your answers evaluated by a team of experts. So the answer writing evaluation will be done on 6 parameters. Now these very 6 parameters are the parameters that UPSC look in your answer when they actually check your answers. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.